Hi guys, welcome to this next part on how to make your arpeggios shine out, sound a lot more organic, have a natural flavor, be played with a lot of dynamics, create a storytelling environment, and more importantly, sound a lot more human and a lot less programmed or robotic, if you will. So I'm doing a few very, very basic things with the arpeggios we learned in the earlier lesson. Let's first recap what we did in the earlier lesson. We took E minor, G major, D major, and A major, and then played them in a flourishing manner using arpeggios. LMHM, low, middle, high, middle. Then we looked at high, middle, low, middle. Then we looked at high, low, middle, low. Now, I'm just going to give you a few tips and a few approaches to just make this sound a lot more professional and put you in an elite group of people in an even playing field of everyone knowing this same stuff. How can you be in a complete different league from these people? So the first thing I'd like to focus on is volume control or dynamics. In order to do that, you take the same arpeggios and you need to create a volume wave, sort of like a person moving on a journey in a hill environment. You go up the hill, it's a little bit more louder, and then you go down the hill, it's a little bit softer, right? And then you come all the way down and you're very, very relaxed because it's sort of soft, and then you go all the way up and it's at the peak of the volume. So you need to try and do this in order to take your listeners on an experience or on a journey, if you will, while they are listening to your song. So this performance may not sound as good as maybe this performance. Has a lot more character, this has a lot more intention, a lot more purpose. This would work if someone gives us lyrics to have a song over. We can play with the lyrics, we can play with the singer. So one way to look at dynamics is just that, you just follow the words of the song or your vocalist. Depending on how the vocalist performs with their emotions, maybe in the chorus you could play louder, maybe in the verse you could play softer, or follow your singer. Maybe in a line itself the singer is getting louder. Very important approach towards developing dynamics is to just let your breathing take control over the sound. By that I mean, if you breathe in, for some reason it's tightening the muscles and the volume appears to be getting, will get rather, a lot more louder. So this really works for me and a lot of the students who I've taught over the years. So I'm sure it'll work for you. So as you play the arpeggio, breathe in and just see what happens. And now I can't breathe in anymore, so I start breathing out. As you breathe out, the volume appears to relax itself and get a bit softer. So just follow your body and play as natural as possible, right? So breathing will really help take your playing to the next level. Of course, you have to control your breathing musically and also not lose time. So it requires a little bit of practice. Perhaps you could do it with the metronome running by your side. So that is one great way to improve the professionalism while you play arpeggios on the piano. Moving on, another great way to look at arpeggios is to play them with the sustain pedal on. So with each chord, see what's happening? The sustain pedal is on. So what that does is it not only sustains the sound, but it also adds additional overtones, which the sustain on a real piano physically does, you know, with the mechanics or the way the sound harmonics are created. The overtones actually add to the sound and create like a very nice warm layer, a pad-like layer, along with your chords, along with the actual piano sound. So without the pedal, even though I'm playing it nice, doesn't sound as full as with the pedal. This is with the pedal. And pedal with volume control. Pedal with dynamics. Breathe in, volume goes up, right? So just these two things alone, you know, can just take your playing to the next level. However, with the pedal comes another responsibility wherein you have to lift it before you change to the next chord. So if I do E minor, I can't hold it like that. All of the overtones are just fighting with each other. They are all coming together. So, well, the only way to overcome that is lift the pedal. You're lifting the hammers off the strings. Lift just before the next chord. Or if you're not so certain, lift it a beat before. 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Right? And 3 and 4 and 1 and 2. And you have to lift it at some point. You cannot hold it. You yourself are going to figure out that the sound is, wow, it's a bit scary because everything is being heard. And the sustain pedal needs to be lifted primarily when your left hand starts going deeper and deeper, which you want as a piano player, right? So these are the two tried and tested ways which I would say professional pianists do. The last way which I wanted to share with you while playing your arpeggios to make it more dynamic is to follow the drummer of your band, and more specifically, wherever you feel the snare drum is going to strike. So if I go, so wherever the snare drum is hitting, you could perhaps accentuate that. You could play that a little louder. So maybe snare. This will work great for rock songs. Snare, kick. So soft kick, loud snare. So you have to imagine the drum groove playing, right? Snare, kick, snare, kick. And so on. Now if you reorder the arpeggio, if you do high, middle, low, middle, so generally the snare hit points will end up being at the 2 and the 4 of the bar. So if I count it out for you, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2, 3 and 4 and 1, 2, 3, right? Every 2 and the 4 you just accentuate, right? So in this lesson we've looked at 3 ways to make your piano arpeggios a lot more professional, a lot more elite, and a lot more organic and human sounding. What is the first method? To just breathe in and breathe out. You breathe in, things get louder. You breathe out, things get softer. And also follow your vocalist and dynamics. In a nutshell, the whole approach, the first suggestion was all about dynamics. Then it's about using the sometimes forgotten sustain pedal. Press it, lift it, and then follow the drums, more particularly the snare drum at the 2 and the 4. So these two lessons, the earlier one and this one, if you haven't watched the earlier one, that'll give you a perspective to do this one a lot better, I'm sure. And head over to the next videos. As we do them, we'll be doing a lot more ways to make simple arpeggio patterns a lot more interesting, a lot more compositional, a lot more unique, and a lot more cool. Again, this is Jason from Nathaniel. Do subscribe to our channel, turn on the bell for notifications, and keep rocking. Cheers.